The first poet I met in my life was my grandmother, and I think that she was the most truest poet that I met in my life. A person who was writing poetry without writing poetry. She was singing poetry, dancing poetry, living poetry. After my grandmother, of course, I met Ahmad Shamlu, which is, I can say that without him, I didn't have the strength to write poetry anymore. The complexity of life and the situation that I was living, if Shamlu were not existing, I was not existing, I was thinking that, okay, let's be like the others. Even to die alive. But his existence gave me that power to write and to continue to write. And then came Clara Hannes. In a meeting that with Shamlu, I met her, and I can say that after Shamlu, nobody could change me that much as Clara changed me. And Clara helped me to know and discover other world poets, which I continued what as a master she taught me. I translated about 300 world poets, which many of them are the trace of what she did in Spanish literature. I translated Vladimir Holand, which later on Vladimir Holand became an influential poet in my own life, which now I consider Holand as part of my body. Then it came Nikita Stanescu, a Romanian poet. Then it came Zbigniew Herbert, a Polish poet. Then it came, of course, Rilke and Trakl, which and Paul Celan, German language poets, which they live in me and they never left me. Of course, there are other poets which influenced me, but the main figures of my life are Holland, Rilke, Stanescu, Herbert, Shamlu, Clara, Antonio Gamoneda, without any doubt, and Hafiz, a Persian poet, and from American literature, perhaps T.S. Eliot and Ezra Pound. These poets were too much influential on me. I never could trace where my poetry exists, but which poets put more impression on me and influence on me, but all of them exist in me, and all of them speaks in me. And I'm a small student of all of them, but at the same time, they speak in me. And whatever I have is what they gave me, and that's all.